Hi everybody, I'm Ryan, and today we're going to talk about Magic the Gathering news, like we do every single week. If you want Magic the Gathering news every single Friday, please be sure to subscribe. I really, really appreciate it. That being said, Worlds is this weekend in Las Vegas, along with MagicCon. I have some friends going out there, and one friend competing. Good luck, Aiden. I'm really excited to watch Worlds, to watch the development of the standard format and the pushing of the standard format. It's going to be a blast to watch and cheer, you know, my friend and the best players in the world on. I don't really have any other news about Worlds. I'm sure the next news episode, we're going to be recapping Worlds and kind of talking about it. But I got to move on from that. Also, a very large announcement is that Magic has continued talking about the Commander format panel, and they announced a few things in, you know, this big encapsulating announcement. The first thing is that they decided to make a panel of people that will make decisions on the Commander format, because the whole point of Commander is that it's a community-made format. It has historically been community run, and they want it to continue being community run, just with oversight from Wizards of the Coast. So these people are the ones that will be making decisions about Commander. They also said they're going to have a Discord that they talk about the state of Commander from week to week. They also decided to go ahead with the different brackets of Commander. Now, the different brackets haven't been announced. They're not ready. They wanted originally to debut it in Las Vegas, but basically they're going to be different ban lists for different levels of Commander. So rather than saying my deck's a 7 or whatever, you can say that my deck is in this bracket. With the asterisk that these brackets and the ban list in general is totally optional. Like, Commander's a pretty casual format besides CEDH and, you know, a dual Commander on Modo. So we'll see when that's actually announced what future of Commander is going to look like. As far as Magic Arena goes, there's a big announcement that they're doing an emergency ban on Leyline of Resonance in Best of One in Standard and Alchemy. Leyline of Resonance was just leading to absolutely insane fast aggro decks in Best of One, and especially with the Best of One Shuffler, it was just kind of destroying it. And I'll read the synopsis of the announcement. We love fast and fun Magic. This is especially true for MTG Arena, where the guiding philosophy is fast, fun Magic for everyone, anywhere. What is critical is that it be fast and fun for both players involved. Fast without the fun undermines the purpose of playing the game, and this is the issue both we and the player community have observed with Leyline of Resonance on MTG Arena. It disrupts normal play in Best of One Constructed matches, and has led to the decision to ban the card in Best of One Standard Constructed only on MTG Arena, and suspend it in Alchemy until the release of a rebalanced card. Also, they announced a new Secret Lair drop that is going to be teaming with Marvel, which is kind of excited. Secret Lair, Marvel versions of a ton of different cards, along with individual versions and new versions of these Marvel heroes. Here's a bunch of pictures of them. It's really, really exciting. Magic Arena has also announced the play-in dates. November 16th for the qualifier play-in is a standard Best of One. On 17th, there's also a bonus Best of One qualifier, so that's kind of exciting. That's Magic Foundations Limited. The best of three qualifier is November 22nd, and actual qualifier weekend is November 23rd and 24th, which is standard. As far as Magic Online news, is Magic Online is going to be at MagicCon, which is where the World Championships are being held in Las Vegas, in room S204, where there are going to be Magic Online PlayStations, a bunch of giveaways, a MagicCon avatar that you can get. In addition, on Magic Online this weekend is a triple qualifier weekend. On Friday and Saturday are a pair of limited qualifiers, and on Sunday is a standard qualifier where the top two finishers in each of these tournaments qualify for the regional championship. And that is it for Magic the Gathering news. If you like this video and want more Magic the Gathering news, please be sure to like and subscribe. Check me out on social medias. Links are above me and in the description. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.